Please hit the bell along with the subscribes button as you listen. David Douglas Duncan was born on January 23, 1916 and died at June 7, 2018. He was an American photojournalist who is best known for his dramatic combat photographs. Duncan was born in Kansas City, Missouri, where his childhood was marked by interest in the outdoors, helping him earn the rank of Eagle Scout in the Boy Scouts at a relatively young age. A lantern slide presentation by big game hunter and physician Richard L. Sutton, Sr., M.D., at Duncan's elementary school in Kansas City inspired an early interest in photography and world travel. Duncan briefly attended the University of Arizona, where he studied archaeology. While in Tucson, he inadvertently photographed John Dillinger trying to get into a hotel. Duncan eventually continued his education at the University of Miami, where he graduated in 1938, having studied zoology and Spanish. It was in Miami that his interest in photojournalism began in earnest. He worked as picture editor and photographer of the university paper. His career as a photojournalist began when he took photographs of a hotel fire in Tucson, Arizona, while he was then studying archaeology at nearby University of Arizona. His photos included one of a hotel guest who made repeated attempts to go back into the burning building for his suitcase. That photo proved to be newsworthy when the guest turned out to have been notorious bank robber John Dillinger and the suitcase to have contained the proceeds of a bank robbery in which he had shot a police officer. Unfortunately, after the film was turned over to the Tucson Citizen, it was lost forever, and the photos were never printed. After college, Duncan began to freelance, selling his work to journals such as the Kansas City Star, Life and the National Geographic magazine. In 1966 he published Yankee Nomad, a visual autobiography that collected representative photographs from throughout his career. In 2003 this was revised and published under the title of Photo Nomad. Duncan traveled extensively in the Middle East, having been stationed there 10 years after World War II for Life magazine. He later published The World of Allah in 1982. He died at 102 years old.